Yes, and we got him.
Really superb fish imitation, especially if you fish it with an intermediate line.
Oh, he's a big one.
Fantastic fish. Absolutely beautiful. We must put her back.
Wonderful new dimension to fly fishing. Fishing of any kind of fish.
It's Amber. It's the
reason it gives you a battle on this time.
Oh, and off he goes. Superb.
I've never caught a carp before, and that's mainly due to the fact that until recently there haven't been any to catch here in Northern Ireland. Now, I do know that carp fishermen have a wee bit of a reputation. They're slightly nuts. There's no other group of anglers, it seems, that pursues just one species of fish with such relentless determination. This is Northern Ireland's first ever carp fishery, and I've come here today not just to try to catch my first fish, but to find out what it is that keeps those anglers so firmly hooked on catching just carp.
Hello, what about you?
Mark McGivern.
That's me, a very man.
So what's the fishing like today?
Not too bad at all, Alan, to be honest with you.
It's a bit windy, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a bit windy, but that suits the carp.
I suppose it'll give them a wee bit of cover. Oh, they're nervous fish, aren't they?
Very nervous.
Are you aware, Mark, that I don't have a clue what I'm doing here?
Well,
I've never ever caught a carp before.
I'll not hold that against you.
thanks a bunch. Well, hopefully by the time I'm done, I'll have broken my duck, but maybe you'd give me, I don't know, 5 minutes, just talk me through what we're doing.
No problem.
Show me the tackle.
All no problem.
All right, excellent.
Let's go.
That's not a bad looking old day after all.
Not bad at all. This is the reel most associated with carp anglers. It's the Shimano bait runner, which basically means it has a free spool facility.
Yeah, and this rod, that's one of these big heavy rods.
Well, actually, this is one that's slightly lighter. It's about 1 1/4. It's more suitable for this venue, but rods usually for carp fishing are in the range of 2 3/4 pound test carp.
So when you fish for these, are you you're ledgering all the time?
I'm ledgering, but in carp fishing we use a thing called a hair rig.
Yes, I've heard of a hair rig.
If I can just
what
show
is
you,
a hair rig?
I'd love
to see what that is. But isn't the hair rig where you have a little half pound line where the hook sits loose by the...
Yes, that is the general idea, but that's your basic hair rig there.
Because I always thought that a hair rig was a situation where you had a really fine line joining onto the bait, whereas you've got really thick line there.
Well, it used to be like that. It used to be you could use fine line on, but you get the same presentation, and I suppose it's much more easier to tie doing it this way with the same length of hook link material.
Because I thought that the idea was sensitivity, where the carp didn't actually see the heavy line coming out of the bait or out of the hook.
Well, if I can show you, I have one here that already has the bait on it. This is the bait most associated with carp fishing.
So this is a hair rig as well?
Yes, and this is the bait on the hair rig. These are boilies. Now, if you can imagine, I'll just show you, I'll just take this off. That's the material going through the bait there. So really, there's no real need for the fine material. This stuff does the job adequately.
So it's not the presence of the hook that actually frightens the fish?
Because
that hook's right on top of the bait.
Well, exactly. The presence of the main reason why the hair rig is, if you can imagine the boilie, if you can feel it yourself there, it's quite a hard bait, it's quite a tough bait, right?
What's that made out of?
If you imagine that the same sort of powders that the bodybuilders mix up for their high protein drinks, that's what's in this stuff.
Yeah.
It basically, in angling terms, carp are the Arnold Schwarzeneggers of the freshwater world. They really are. They're
powerful fish.
Powerful fish.
So do you lob all this out just on a standard ledger rig with an Arsley bomb or something like that?
No, this is the next part of it. We use quite heavy leads, 2 ounce.
Oh, that's a brute of a lead.
Oh yeah.
I mean, you're only looking at a lob here for 20
yards.
Well,
exactly. But you see, what you're aiming to achieve is the fact that when we fool the carp into taking the bait, he'll feel the resistance of the lead. And he'll take off, he'll scream off, a bolt effect.
And that's why
it's called the bolt rig.
So it's the lead that actually hooks the fish.
This carp fishing is like the ultimate lazy man sport. We use electronic bite indicators to tell us when a fish is on. I'm just going to show you one now.
Right, okay, let's have a look at one of those. That's something that certainly I've never used before, Mark.
This is a piece of work.
Oh, it's a small little thing, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. But the idea is that when we cast a rod out, right?
Yeah.
We put a rod on top of this. That has a wee wheel, right, inside it. Now, don't ask me. I'm the electronics expert. But whenever, if you imagine this is your line going out to the fish.
Oh, that's very sensitive.
That tells you. And you have a light on there as well in the dark to tell you, which stays on for 10 seconds after you find.
So obviously you can put the noise off.
Yeah, you can turn it right down if you wish, you know.
But I mean, evidently then you're not going to have to sit and watch the rod all day.
Exactly.
You can basically...
The whole idea about carp fishing is to go, relax, wind down, and it's a contrast. You're sitting in this peaceful environment, the habitat, you're blending in with it, and then all of a sudden, out of nowhere, you have a fish.
Yeah.
Now it screams off a lot louder than that. In a sense that it goes non-stop. And it's that contrast of quietness and tranquility 1 second,
yes,
and then the next second, bang, yeah, there's an explosion.
Yes. Yeah. But Mark, we've all had bait out there and there's still no juicy fish there.
Well, honestly, I mean, it is a waiting game, you know. It's only a couple of hours yet, like, give it time, you know.
Oh, fish!
Yep, just wait a second. Just wait a second. That's bumped into the line.
Yes, he did.
There's a bubbles coming up, look. Look, see the wee fine bubbles coming up? Just out past the plants.
Yeah, straight out.
Uh-huh.
Over there.
Yep, yep.
Oh, I see the bubbles there again.
Mm-hmm. They're about, boy. I have fished for 5 solid days before I've had a fish. Not here, like, but I've fished for 5... Oh, serious.
5 days?
Oh, yeah. 5, 24 hours locked beside the water. Non-stop.
120 hours.
Whatever it is. Yep. 120 hours. Yep. 120
You're
hours.
You're joking me.
Before I finally got a fish, 19.4. So, like, I know you're sort of used to the trout angling, and so, you know, if not catch it a couple of hours, move on.
Hang on. Are you telling me? I mean, we've been here now for what? It must be 2.5 hours, and we put all that bait out there, and
yep,
we've seen bubbles.
Yep.
But the fish haven't taken it. So how long am I expected to be sitting here before we get a fish?
Well, I wouldn't put it past. I wouldn't be, you know, 24 hours would be sort of the normal.
No, Mark. 24
serious.
Hours? Yeah. Jeepers, oh, what are we going to do during all
well,
that time?
I've got that. I've sort of thought I'd look after you, even though you are a trout angler sort of thing. But I've prepared this bivvy for you and bed chair, etc. That's not quite home with the mod cons, you know.
Have you got a mobile phone? I've got to call the wife. There's a mobile phone. Well, this is carp fishing, and I have to say it's tough going. I've been here all day and I've seen nothing and caught no fish. In fact, I've been here for just over 8 hours. And I've sat in this one spot, I'm not allowed to move. Mark's advised me this is the spot. And the problem is, there's absolutely nothing to do. You just sit here and watch. If I was fly fishing, I'd be up and casting and moving around looking for fish. And I don't even have anything to actually look at, you know, there's no float. I'm just waiting for this thing to go bleep, 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 bleep. I might as well be playing a game of cards or sitting in my bivvy. In fact, it's more like camping. than it is fishing. I really don't think I'm going to catch a fish here. But I'm determined. I really am going to stay here until I get my first carp. I'll probably spend the night here in this little tent. In fact, it definitely is more like camping than fishing. Just I think I'll go and see what Mark's left for me.
Many people say angling is boring. They wouldn't have the patience to sit all day doing nothing, they say. Now, I'm a committed fly fisherman, and that doesn't involve much sitting around, but this carp fishing really does. It's by far the least active type of fishing I've ever tried. The day slipped comfortably past, but the only things moving were the pages of my book. Carp fishing is setting a trap and waiting patiently until it's sprung, whereas fly fishing is much more like active hunting. I suppose it's all down to personal preferences in the end. Until now, I had no idea just how completely different two angling disciplines could be. I mean, this is as different as golf is from tiddlywinks. If I put my philosopher's hat on, I'd say carp anglers are like cats. Cats will sit by a mouse hole for hours, waiting patiently just for one chance. On the other hand, fly fishermen are like wild dogs that chase their prey for hours until they get a result. Yep, I'm fairly sure it's got something to do with the kind of person you are. But I'm definitely cut from the wild dog cloth. And that's probably why carp anglers are so dedicated to this, because they're all cats and it suits them perfectly. Oh well, I guess carp anglers must all be good philosophers with all this time on their hands.
And they're still just the same. Why is that no surprise?
I really couldn't face sitting for another whole day, so I decided to have a go with a fly rod, more to give me something to do than anything else.
I mean, what about trying to cast here?
Exactly, I don't think we're doing any harm at all, Alan, to be honest with you.
Right, so you're just going to land that in,
yeah.
Wherever you see a bubble. Yeah. I'm going to try a fly. Mark, I really haven't got a clue what I'm doing with the fly here, but if you say they eat nymphs, I've put on a good weighted nymph, and I think I'll fish it on the draw. What I'm going to do is cast out, let it sink, and then when I do a draw, the nymph just comes up steadily from the bottom.
Yes,
and that might just induce a take. I really haven't got a clue whether it will or not, okay. But that's probably the best I can do. But I would give my back teeth to catch one on the fly. I'd say probably I'd be one of the first carp anglers ever to catch the first carp on a fly.
Really put a line out on.
Oh, that's a short line, Mark.
Is it?
Oh yeah, it's a short line.
How far can you cast with a fly line?
It depends on the fly line that you have. With a shooting head, you can cast 40 yards with a following breeze. I suppose it's down to practice and timing, but shooting heads definitely give you more distance ability than full length line. Yes! Yes, I'm in! Mark! This is certainly a rod that's capable of handling really big fish. Oh! That's another thing I'm not... Oh, and I can't stop him going in there. That's another thing I'm not used to, is having two lines in the water. He very nearly collected that other rod. But from what I can gather, he's certainly not a big carp, but... Nevertheless, it's my first carp. And if I lost them now, I tell you, I would be sicker than I have ever been in my life. Having waited now, this is well into my second day. And suddenly, out of the blue, after thinking this is never going to happen, suddenly, out of the blue, we have a fish. Now, I think I have him. Oh, and up you come, girl. That is marvelous. Yes! After all that, that is my first ever carp. And I never thought that I would have appreciated one fish as much as I do this one. That is just marvelous. See, he is just impossibly fat. Oh! No, that's the first time I've ever had a carp in my hands. A mirror carp. This is about as small a carp as you're going to get out of this fishery, I think. Mark has told me 6, 7, 8 pounds. When he was coming in, I would have given him about 5 pounds, but getting him in my hands, I'd say he's probably quite a bit heavier. Mark, have you got the...
Yep, that's what we'll do.
Excellent.
We weigh him in the net for you.
Yep.
Well, that's reading 10 pound 11, so you take off a pound.
He's 9 pound 11.
9 pound 11.
I nearly caught a double on my first fish.
Not bad.
There's not too many freshwater species in the UK
not
you
bad.
Can say that about, eh?
Not bad.
That was excellent, Mark. Let me shake your hand. Thank you for putting up with me.
You're welcome, Alan.
And for lending
You're
me your bivvy.
Hopefully I'll see you again.
I just don't know how you sleep on that bed.
Manage it all right.
Excellent. That's really super. I am chuffed to bits with that. The interesting thing about carp fishing is that it's completely different to any other fishing that I've done. This goes from 0 to 100% in literally 1 second. There's nothing. You go to bed at night, there's nothing. You get up the next day, there's nothing. You think there's only ever going to be nothing. And then suddenly, bang, it all goes off. And your adrenaline levels go from 0 right up to max. And this fish, I have to say, I really value my first ever carp, because boy, did I have to work hard for it. And that's fishing.
Mm-hmm.